Hi, this is Jason Warner from Pacific Wastewater Optimization. Today we're going to talk about why rectangular basins are great candidates for optimization. So I want to start with a typical cross-section from a rectangular clarifier. Here we have the inlet gates. Sometimes there's a target baffle mounted in that inlet, which can introduce a downward component into the inlet velocities, and it also tends to smash up any particles that either have begin to come together or that are coming in from the sewer together, and we actually break those particles up. And then I want to point out that, unlike a circular basin, there's no flocculation well. And I think in the late 90s and early 2000s, our industry really took a step forward in paying a lot of attention to the design of flocculation wells. And even to this day, we don't see the analog in rectangular basins. And so as we start to focus in on improving rectangular basins, we have this opportunity to put a canopy baffle over the sludge hopper that helps protect the hopper, the settled sludge, and also a little bit of the beginning of the blanket. We also introduce this flocculation baffle, and this is in the model. We're able to calculate the open area of this, and so we very specifically design the depth, its position within the tank, and then its open area. And so this is what those concepts look like in a basin. So here we have our canopy baffle that's protecting the sludge hopper, and I wanted to be able to see both two sets of baffles in this tank, and so I pushed the inlet or this set of baffles up towards the inlet. Normally this would be sitting back a little bit, but we create this great zone for flocculation. We normalize flows across the width of the tank, and we cut off any high velocity currents across the top of the tank using this first set of baffles. And then this is the other reason that rectangular basins make great candidates for optimization. Because we're able to correct flows at multiple locations across the axis of the tank, we can introduce a secondary set of baffling and a third set of baffling to really make the most out of the existing concrete that's available to us in a rectangular basin. If you'd like help with taking a look at your primaries or your secondary basin, be it rectangular basins or circular, I'd be happy to hop on a phone call with you and kind of see what your goals are and see if they're a match with the methods and the technology that we offer. Thank you.